Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
You're watching Southeast Headlines and have the top stories we are tracking for you on Monday the 22nd of July. India's finance minister presents economic survey, pegs growth at 7%. Bangladesh calm day after top court scrapped some job quotas. And Nepal PM Modi secures trust vote with two-thirds majority. And now for all the details. A day ahead of presenting the annual budget for the upcoming year, India's Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman tabled the Economic Survey 2023-24 and kicked off the Parliament's budget session. The survey says that the country's economy has recovered swiftly from the pandemic, with its real GDP in financial year 2024 being 20% higher than the pre-COVID levels. The survey also indicates an economic growth at a rate of 7%. It notes that the biggest disruption for the future of the work is the accelerated growth in AI, which is poised to revolutionize the global economy. Sitharaman will table the government's first budget of PM Modi's third term on Tuesday. The budget session of the parliament that began on Monday will have 16 sittings spread over 22 days. A firefight was underway in Rajouri district of India's Jammu and Kashmir territory after terrorists attacked the house of a member of the village defence committee in the wee hours of Monday. In a statement, the defence spokesperson said terrorists attacked the house in Gunda village of Rajouri, after which the nearby army column reacted and a firefight ensued. Tactical teams swiftly intervened, ensuring no harm to the VDC member and his family. Operations are continuing and firefight is in progress, the statement added. In the last few months, there has been a spike in terror attacks in the Jammu region, including the attack on an army convoy in Kathua and encounters in Doda and Udhampur. Defence experts have said such actions by terrorists is to disrupt peace and create mayhem in the region on the directives of the Pakistan spy agency ISI.
जो 44-50 के जो टेररिस्ट हैं यहाँ पे अभी पीर पंचाल के अंदर, इनका जो काम है वो यही है कि ISI के जो इशारे हैं कि आप भाई यहाँ पे ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा जो है लोगों के बीच में दहशत फैलाएं, और इसी संदर्भ में अभी ये अटैक हुआ है यहाँ पे। इससे पहले आपने देखा कैसे पहले भी रियासी में हुआ, मछेड़ी में हुआ, डोडा में हो रहा है, पर ये जो VDC के मेंबर पे घर के ऊपर अटैक है ये साफ दिखाता है कि ये लोग घबरा गए हैं, क्योंकि अब VDC उसको एम्पावर हो गया है। अब ये चाहते हैं कि VDC इसके ऊपर प्रेशर पड़े ताकि VDC जो है ना तो वो रिएक्ट करें और ना ही वो आगे आए उसके लिए जो है जो एंटी टेररिस्ट ऑपरेशंस के अंदर।
Meanwhile, Pakistan's Power Minister Awais Leghri on Sunday said that this month Islamabad will ask Chinese power plants operating in the country to shift to using coal from Pakistan's Thar region rather than imported coal. Leghri said Islamabad may also begin talks on pre-profiling Pakistan's energy sector dead during the visit to Beijing. The minister will be a part of the delegation to discuss structural reforms to the power sector suggested by the IMF, which last week agreed on a $7 billion bailout for the heavily indebted South Asian nation. Neighbouring China has set up over $20 billion worth of energy projects in Pakistan. Such a transition would benefit the Chinese-owned plants in Pakistan by reducing pressure on Islamabad's foreign exchange reserves, making it easier to repatriate dividends and offering a better return in dollar terms. Pakistan's power sector has been plagued by high rates of power theft and distribution losses, resulting in accumulating debt across the production chain, a concern raised by the IMF.
The purpose of me going along is the conversion of our imported coal units to the local Thar coal. That would have a huge impact on the cost of energy of power in the near future. So that is one of the biggest agendas of the power sector. We are also going to be briefing our Chinese partners on the reforms that we already have started working on, and we are well into it. The privatization process of the distribution companies, investment into the transmission constraints that Pakistan has. Other than that, we are also looking at introduction of technology into our distribution companies.
Moving on, Pakistani police on Monday arrested jailed former PM Imran Khan's PTI party information secretary Rauf Hasan for heading a digital media cell allegedly involved in running propaganda against Pakistan and its integrity. The party, in a statement on X, said it's absolutely shameful how Islamabad police continues to completely mock and disregard every law in this country. Law of the jungle is reigning over Pakistan. PTI chief Imran Khan has now been in jail for about 1 year, even though all 4 convictions handed down to him have either been suspended or overturned. His party secured the largest number of seats in parliament in the election in February, despite efforts by what it says is a military-backed crackdown that aims to keep Imran Khan out of power. Bangladesh appeared calm on Monday amid a curfew, a day after the Supreme Court scrapped some quotas for government jobs that sparked protests this month that killed more than 130 in the South Asian nation. There were no reports of violence or protest on Monday morning, and media reports said curfew was relaxed for 3 hours in the afternoon, extended from 2 hours the previous day, so that the people could buy essentials. Bangladesh government had imposed curfew and deployed military on Friday after nationwide unrest broke out following student anger against the quotas for government jobs, which included 30% reserved for the families of those who fought for independence from Pakistan. Hasina's government had scrapped the quota system in 2018, but a court reinstated it last month. However, the Supreme Court this past weekend ordered that 93% of government jobs should be allocated on the basis of merit, against earlier quotas of 56%. Student protesters have said they plan to continue demonstrations until the release of detained protest leaders, and have demanded the government to lift the curfew and reopen universities shut since Wednesday. They have set a 48-hour deadline for the government to act on the demands.
এই কারফুর কারণে মনে করি যে আন্দোলন চলতেছে ইয়া চলতেছে এই কারণে যে কারিগরি চলতেছে না সব বন্ধ তারা খুব রিক্স আনতেছে মাল আইনা যে দিতেছে এটা ধন্যবাদ তাদের
যারা দোকান খুলছে আমরা তো আসছি দেরিতে পয়সা দেখি কি বাজার একবারে নীরব আর দুপুরের পরে আজান দেওয়ার পরের থেকে মনে করেন মৌমাছির মতন বেড়া দিয়ে নেছে কাস্টমার
Nepal Prime Minister KP Sharma Oli secured a two-third majority in the vote of confidence motion tabled in the parliament on Sunday. Oli received 188 votes in the 275-member parliament, with 74 votes against the motion. The Prime Minister required at least 138 votes to win the trust motion. Oli, who heads the moderate CPN-UML, had forged alliance with Nepali Congress last month to form a new government. He took office on July 15, 3 days after his predecessor Pushpa Kamal Dehal lost a parliamentary vote of confidence. Nepal has been politically unstable since it abolished a 239-year-old monarchy in 2008. Oli's new government is the 14th since that time. And thousands of devotees took holy dip in sacred Ganga River and crowded temples across northern India to mark the first Monday of the Hindu holy month of Shravan. The Mondays of Shravan are considered to be one of the most auspicious days as per the Hindu calendar, and devotees worship Lord Shiva, the god of destruction, during Shravan and seek his blessings for peace and prosperity of their families. As part of the rituals, devotees offer milk, bilwa leaves and honey to the Shiva Lingam, the phallus representation of Lord Shiva.
बहुत अच्छा दिन है सावन का महीना अपने आप में उत्साह लेके आता है मेरे अंदर बहुत अच्छा वो था इसलिए मैं पैदल लेके आई हूँ द्वार मीनाक्षीपुरम से जल लेके पैदल आई नंगे पैर
On Monday, devotees known as Kavariyas also began the annual tradition of collecting holy water from River Ganga to tread back home, carrying it in pods tied to a bamboo pole. A special procession was also organized in Varanasi on the occasion, which saw devotees playing damru, the percussion instrument of Lord Shiva.
और सब गंगा जल लेकर के बाबा के धाम में डमरू बजाते हुए जा रहे हैं। ये सब आनंदित है, इसमें किसी का एक्सप्लेन नहीं किया जा सकता है, ये आनंद की अनुभूति है और सब इसका आनंद ले रहे हैं सब लोग।
That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time.
Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.